Racist NFL players caught hiding sick secret weapon on the field that could be deadly, NFL does nothing. While most of the responsible adults in America with any foresight whatsoever have already abandoned the National Football League because of its disrespect to the nation, there is at least one more habit that players have that could put holdouts over the edge. Anyone who considered the NFL to have any integrity left is now faced with a trend that completely blows that theory out of the water. While we know that many common drugs are banned by the league for use by the players, it turns out that players can get a boost from something else, a backdoor if you will. Taking a medication orally is the most common way of getting a substance into your bloodstream, but it's not the only way. Players and even team staff have been caught sniffing performance-enhancing substances, and the league doesn't seem to care. Dallas Cowboys player Ezekiel Elliott was the subject of an ESPN expose about the players, throughout the league who have started huffing an ammonia mixture for a little sideline pick-me-up between downs. Elliott and a handful of his Cowboys teammates are breathlessly engaged in the latest, strangest sports ritual, huffing the stomach-turning noxious fumes found in smelling salts. The ammonia-based inhalant is manufactured for the express purpose of treating or preventing fainting, but at some point, NFL players and other athletes discovered they could repurpose the decongestant properties and adrenaline-pumping side effects into a perfectly legal, low-tech pick-me-up, even though there's zero proof of any performance benefit. In fact, this will be the first of at least 8 capsules for Elliott today. Using hand movements reminiscent of his trademark feed me gesture, Elliott inhales a capsule before donning his helmet for each Dallas drive in a 35-30 loss to the Rams. He's far from alone, on either team. Directly behind Elliott, two members of the Cowboys game day staff, dressed in matching blue slacks and white polos, are busy sniffing away on their own ammonia capsules. It's understood that professional athletes are under a tremendous amount of strain, both physically and physiologically, while they play the game. However, these habits are a notch or two above having a cup of coffee with your morning paper, and the after effects are really not at all new. The article likens them to a decongestant, but it's worth noting that any medication, over-the-counter or otherwise, has a recommended dosage. If there's a decongestant that recommends that you take 8 over the course of a couple of hours, I've yet to see it. ITS is a basically unregulated substance because it's more commonly used for cleaning, and we're recommended to not have it near our faces, and yet these players are huffing it like it's their life support. The reality is that this substance that is supposed to help them be more alert and attentive while playing, might, in reality, be causing them to ignore the warning signs of brain damage. Here's more from our source about the effects this dangerous habit could have on professional athletes. Near the end of the first half, 6 members of the Dallas defense can be seen simultaneously hitting the salts before taking the field. The group includes veteran cornerback Orlando Scandrick, who jogs onto the field while using his right hand to make the sign of the cross and his left hand to sniff salts, and defensive end DeMarcus Lawrence, the NFL's sack leader through 4 games. Lawrence says he can't drink coffee for a quick jolt during the game because it might affect his stomach, so he has turned to smelling salts. The ammonia wakes you up, opens your eyes, Lawrence explains. You'll be on the bench, you start to get a little tired and you got to wake your body up, and that's what that little ammonia does for you. But that